My name is Gabriella Pession, and I'm playing Eva Vittoria, which is, of course, an Italian character. For me to work with actors from other places and, you know, other countries, it's very challenging in a way, because it's not just the languages that it's kind of, you know, it's interesting to hear different accents and, you know, even on the emotional level, like the way we use our emotions, or the way we handle a case, or the way we respond to each other is just different, because we really are different. Like, we have, you know, a French actor, American, then we have Irish and Italian. And it's just like, for example, my character, Eva, she's super emotional, like really kind of warm, really empathetic, and really, you know, alive, like a volcano. So that's like, that's really Italian. So to see, you know, all this different kind of culture together, it's really interesting, even in the story, because you can see, you live the same event, but with different, you know, perspective. So it's really interesting. And with the thing that is the best is just, we're really having a lot of fun. Like, this group, I've been doing, you know, interview for movies, you know, all my career, and all the time you say, oh, you know, we are an amazing casting. But this time, it's just extraordinary. Like, maybe because it's multicultural, maybe because we just come from different places, so we kind of laugh at each other, we share things, we just, it's really challenging. Well, we live together, like, now we are like a family, and me, Richard, and Tom, we live in the same residence, so we kind of really live together. And I just adore them. I'm like, it's the first time I was watching the makeup artist, Linda and Gabby. They're just amazing. I mean, it's just an amazing group. And then we're putting 12, because we have 12 days left. And usually I'm really happy, and this time I'm not, because Prague is amazing. It's a very cozy little town. It's super romantic. It's one of the most beautiful places I've ever seen in my entire life. I'm European, but Prague, I have to say, probably is my favorite town in Europe. So I shoot in the best place, and, you know, we shoot all day, and then we have dinner. Sometimes I go to the gym, I do a massage, but basically we spend a lot of time together and we never get bored. Like, we're looking for each other's, and we just did a trip to Dresda, because Tom is from Dresda, so we went to visit his grandfather, who's 97. And so we went there, and we were planning to do things even after the movie together. I mean, it's just, it's really rare. I have to say, I was talking with my mom on the phone today. I have to say, in 15 years of career, this is the best time ever for me. Well, first of all, I knew at Bernero work before, so I'm a fan of Criminal Minds, so I know that he was involved in the project. So when they first called me to, you know, to talk to me about this project, I was like curious, because he is what he is. And so that was the main thing. And then, because I was born in the United States, so I'm half American and half Italian, and I've always wanted to kind of work international, like, not just in my country, which I adore, but it's very tiny and the market is very small. So the first, like, you know, I have to be honest, like, when they talked to me about this, I was already interested, because the project seemed to be really, you know, incredible, like international and just super cool. Then, of course, I read the role. It was even better, because she was like the heart of the team. She's like, you know, an expert with weapons, and it was just super cool. So it's an action movie, you work with Ed Bernero, you work internationally, you travel around Europe with an amazing cast. I mean, Donald Sutherland was attached to the project. He was like, I think I'm gonna say yes for sure. So that's what happened. I've done a lot of training, and the stuntmen here are just amazing. Like, in Czech Republic, we have amazing people training us. Even in France, we have had a really good trainer for a kung fu scene, like a fight scene, and it was a French stuntman, and it's just so much fun. I love to, you know, learn different things. So for me, even though I was scared in the first place to use all these weapons, then I say I might as well try and just live it, because I have to be here for, you know, I don't know how long, so I might as well just have to enjoy it and just try it and have fun. And that's what happened. Well, we talk for hours on the phone. We have our girly talk, And when I met her in Paris, I love because she's tough. I love because she's like, she doesn't have any, you know, I can't stand when people are like, hi, and then they kill you behind the shoulders. Me and Rolla, sometimes I'm like, you know, I don't think this, we have kind of confrontation, but it's so sincere, it's so direct. And I think she's, I adore her because she's a mother, she's a wife, and she's an amazing businesswoman. So for me, this is like being, you know, it's my, I think this is just amazing to find in a woman those three things. So she can be, and she's so good because she's really human. Like she listen and she can put herself in other positions to really kind of understand what's happening. And as a producer, it's very important because you have to have different point of views. And she's really kind of, you know, able to listen and to try to understand and to fix things in a really understanding, empathetic, constructive way. Working with Ed Bernero, I think is, as an actress, I will wish for every actress on this planet Earth and on the universe to work with this guy because it's just, I'm in love with Ed. I don't know what else to say. He's leaving on Saturday and I have an abandonment issue in my life. With him, it's gonna be even worse because I'm just, I don't know, he's just so human, he's so simple, he's just so real. There's no structures, like, you know, it's just so easy to talk to him. It's like, for me, I just feel home with him. I feel safe. I have fun, and it seems, and it's just making me feel really protected as an actress and as a person as well on set. Like if I have, you know, some problems on some days, maybe I'm more sad or more nervous, whatever. With that, it's very easy to talk. Like, you know, for actors, sometimes it's difficult because this business is so hard that you have to be, you know, always the tough, always prepared, always super cool, diplomatic, and blah, 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 and all this horrible stuff, always, this does have nothing to do with acting and the roles, but it's part of the business. And with him, it's just not like this. It's just simple. It's like talking to my best friend. So for me, I mean, I can talk for hours about Ed. I know that Mark Levoine says that he's like champagne, but I'm gonna say he's like a beer because we have sometimes, I don't drink. So all these guys are telling me, come on, Gab, let's have a pint, let's have a glass of wine, whatever. So I was telling Ed, okay, he said that you are a champagne. To me, you are like a big beer. Now I have the funniest thing ever. We were shooting in Paris. We were having this scene in the middle of this room, like Anne-Marie was lost in the park, like, you know, in the pilot. So all the team is really worried, and we all meet each other in Paris around this table, and Sebastian is telling us, you know, guys, I'm going to show you this kanjen. The word makes me laugh. I can't pronounce this word. It's just, for some reason, it's like every time he says kanjen, I'm going like this. So we were shooting the scene, and then, you know, nothing was on the table because it's going to be in a post-production. And so he opened this candy, but he was doing like, have you seen that Fantasia when the wizard is start like going like, and he starts saying Hans weit rei to make it bigger, like, you know, to open this. And I start laughing to death. They have to not put me in camera. I couldn't, like, I did 10 takes. I was dying, and I say, please, Tom, just don't, because he's German, so he just saw like Zeins weit rei like this, and I saw that thing, and he was like kind of moving his hand the way he was making magic. It's this kanjen, it was this amazing thing that I haven't seen yet because, you know, it's going to be in post-production, but I think it's his toy, and we are all amazed at what he does. Like, he's just so super technical, and for me it's also really interesting because I'm like, I've learned how to send an email like 6 months ago probably. I'm like the worst person with internet. I don't know how to do anything. I still send postcards with the stamp and my writing. So for me, seeing someone who's so technical and I'm like so old fashioned, it's quite interesting. The studios are amazing. We're shooting in this place that, to me, I mean, you've seen it. It's just unbelievable. Then we have an amazing train there, our chopper. It's just so, I love to come in the studios. I feel home here. This is the place where Sebastian does all his kanjen stuff, whatever. That's our room there. That's actually my computer. So it's just so cool. Well, I think it's really interesting because they did a lot of crime series in the world, and an amazing one. Like, it's not a new thing, that's for sure, but they did many things. But this one, it's new because it's around Europe. So it's not just different. First of all, the cast is international, so we really have, it's exotic. You feel different kind of vibes and stuff. And also the places that we're going to, and the different crimes, and you know, this is something that is more global. And I'm European, even though I was born in America and I live in America most of my time, but I feel it's just amazing for people to see how beautiful Europe is and to be around this amazing country that is just, that basically they do a lot of them in America and then they go international. But then if we do like a crime scene in Italy, maybe it just stays local in my own country, or in Germany, stays just in Germany. This one is actually opening to international, you know, it's going crossing lines.